But you were about to say Sammy Guevara and Andrade, this drama that's happening on Twitter.
I have to tell you, it annoyed the shit out of me when I saw it, right? Like, I was like, no, guys, come on. Like, if it's a work, right? If it's a work, and I hope it is. I don't like seeing
it's a bad work if it is.
It's bad because the timing, like, I'm exhausted. And I think most of the viewers are exhausted of the fighting, like the sidebar fighting that's happening. You know, and you're seeing it with, you know, like the MJF stuff. Like, he did it. He said something about he'll never wrestle Eddie Kingston, you know, that slob or something. Like, okay, you know what? They're working. That doesn't bother me. But, you know, I do want to see Andrade more on TV. I am a fan of Andrade's. And, you know, like, this kind of adds more to the conversation of, you know, their guys went there. They're unhappy. They're not in the position they thought they'd be in, whether or not it's true or not. You know, it's the overall perception. So when you have these tweets happen, right, it is, oh, wow, is it real? Is it not real? Is the thing that intrigues you. The is it real does not intrigue me whatsoever with this, because it did happen and it was real when it did happen. And we saw the outcome. They lost four of their top stars in the company.
Yep.
One, like, literally 1, 2, 3, and 4 in it could be 1, 2, 3, and 4 on a number of people's lists. Kenny Omega not being there bugs the crap out of me. It really bothers me. CM Punk having, you know, losing his mind and then that whole fight really bugs me. The Bucks not being there really bugs me. So
yeah, okay. So here's the thing where I think if I knew either of these
again, Tony, I'm not mad at you, Tony. Yelling at Tony. No, I'm not mad at AEW. No. I'm just
that. So if I knew either of these guys, I think the thing that I would tell them is bad timing. We just went through this. Your boss on live camera looked terrible because CM Punk went into business for himself. And so now we get this little Twitter war. And I'm not blaming people here, right? But the fact that Sammy Guevara seems to be in all of these little wars is not a good look for him. But really, it's like, guys, we don't need to see this because we just saw it and it hasn't helped your business in any way. Now, if they believe that maybe the attention is not bad for them, I sort of get that because wrestlers are still, you know, the independent contractors and you know, they're trying to create their own business or whatever. Yeah. But it just looks bad because ultimately, if we believe that the internet fan is so much more a part of the overall fan base in wrestling today, especially with AEW, that internet fan looks at the CM Punk situation and goes, huh, he's supposed to be a good guy, but the reality is maybe he's not that good of a guy. I'm not even laying blame here. I'm just saying that's what the perspective is. That's what it looks like, the optics. I'll use one of your words, the optics of that. And so then, whether you're an Andrade fan or Sammy Guevara fan, the thing that I see out of it, and I'm going to quote the great MVP, and, you know, we don't really curse on this show, but I'll make an exception here. MVP tweeted. MVP tweeted to no one in particular, bitch assery is rampant. Right. And so that's what it looks like to fans. It doesn't look like
it does.
Yeah. Oh, Sammy and Andrade are having a tiff. It just looks like they're both assholes. Like, that's how it comes across.
Ricky wrote something and deleted it. Also, he wrote, man, can my coworker shut the fuck up for a minute?
Right. Because like, if you are supposed to be.
You know, this is urgency. This is all hands on deck, right? Like, I think a lot of people realize that in AEW that, okay, it was funny. It was fun. You know, the back and forth, like, you're a WWE guy. You're here for the money. Like, that was fun. I shouldn't say anybody, right? I'm trying to do better with generalizations this year. That was a thing.
Yes.
Thing that I've tried. You know, when you're doing a show, you kind of like to generalize and you got like to kind of make things bigger, but
because if you go into specifics, then you kind of say things that maybe you're not supposed to say. And
I don't know, man. It just, it's a turnoff for me. It really is, because you're taking me out of the show. Now you're making it seem like you guys really don't like each other. And that doesn't help me. That doesn't make me want to watch more.
Exactly. It makes you feel like why do I want to watch these guys? You know, they're
yeah,
not.
Because it's almost disrespectful. Like, I find it that they're disrespecting the company that they're in, you know, and that's what bothers me the most. Listen, I deal with tremendous staff issues, right? with my
Are
clients.
You saying you this also deal with bitch assery?
I deal with a ton of bitch assery from independent contractors regularly. It's just every work environment, right? But most jobs have the curtain over them where it doesn't leak into the public. You don't have people poking and asking questions 5,000 times a day. They are in the limelight. There's a lot of attention on the company. There has to be some sort of, if you guys keep doing this, you're done. Right? If you guys keep arguing, unless it's all, you know, it's all part of the Tony's big, you know, blending of reality.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the direction that they're going in. I don't know.
You would know more about this than I would, but what kind of leeway does WWE talent have with their social media accounts? Because I've seen Seth reply to certain things where I was like, ah, there's a little edge to that. Like, maybe that was the real guy, not the Seth Rollins character. But for the most part, like, those guys and the men and women in WWE, they're almost only promotional, and you very rarely see them, you know, go off the script to say with their social accounts. And for this reason, is I'm sure.
Listen, this is exactly why WWE is so controlling. A lot of those guys are afraid to post stuff, right? And that's a reality. The difference in the locker rooms is that there are so many different protocols and procedures in WWE. I mean, they are structured very differently than AEW is, and they should be. And this is not a knock at AEW. AEW is 3 years old. Literally 3 years old tomorrow. A lot of these scenarios have not been put in place, and it's not Tony's fault. These are all learning things. You know, you don't want to start restricting and regulating all, from the beginning, but I think it's time that Tony has a conversation and tells people to shut the F up at this point, you know, or else there's going to be severe consequences. Again, how is that conversation not had? Did it happen? Did it not? Are they going to implement something where this doesn't happen? This is, it's too much infighting, but a lot of the same people.